Hey everyone, Sharon and Hank here. The new year is coming up, and economically, we're seeing mixed thoughts and on what's coming. We have seen economists say everything from things are going to be great
Or doom and
to
gloom.
yeah, and there is no one definite path that we see happening. I put on my economics hat, and I'm looking ahead. I think it's going to be a pretty good year.
I hope you're right.
I think that unemployment is down overall. The stock market, which isn't the economy, is doing pretty well. The indicators that we see show that getting merchandise is not as hard as it has been. We're doing some building in our house, and we haven't had that. The supply chain hasn't been bad, and we've been checking with friends across country doing the same sorts of things. So it's going to be a mixed bag a little bit. And with that in mind, understand there's a lot of reasons for that. Politically, it's okay. Politically, it is what it is. We're just going to put that over there. But we've come back from medical challenges, with COVID. And there's a lot of things. It's one of those weird times in the world. So with that in mind, we grabbed a bunch of strategies that things that you can look for and do so you can take control of your business, take control of your life, and make the next 12 months more successful, more profitable, and more productive than the last 12 months have been.
Regardless of the economy.
Yeah. Why don't we have our list here? Why don't you and I alternate?
Okay.
Do you want to go first?
Sure.
Go for it.
So the first thing that we always do is list the three most important objectives for your business over the next year, right? You need to know what your goals are so that everything
Yeah.
else we talk about are all pointed towards those goals.
And for each of those, it's nice to have the objective. For example, I want more sales. Well, that's great. Good on you. But what are you going to do for that objective of more sales? How are you going to do it? I'm going to begin networking this way. I'm going to join this kind of a networking group. I'm going to run this kind of an ad. What are you going to do? How are you going to get there? And then when are you going to do it? Because if it isn't calendared,
It doesn't get done.
absolutely.
And I'd say be really specific. So as Hank said, if you're going to join a chamber, okay, when are you going to join that chamber? How many
Yep.
meetings are you going to go to? All of those things, just I'm going to run an ad. Okay, that's not really helpful. What kind of an ad? Where are you going to run it? When are you going to, all of those things need to be really, really crystal clear, in each of those sub points on your bullet
Yeah,
list.
so that third one, make sure you're crystal clear on the what you're going to do and the tactics. How are you going to get there? What is it in the ver in the blog that goes along with this? That's the verb noun and date. What am I going to do? How am I going to do it? When am I going to get it done by? The next one, don't think of your year as a whole, because when you think, I'm going to get that done next year, well, your subconscious says, I can take time off because next December includes next year. So don't think of your as a whole. Break it down. In fact, every tactic should have its own process, its own calendar. For an example, let's say that you want to send out a newsletter at the end of every month. Well, it doesn't mean that you sit down on the 30th of the month and put it all together and send it out. Unless you have nothing to do on the 30th. But when you work backwards, let's say you're going to mail it out. If you're going to mail it out, well, you have to have time for the printer to get it and get it back to you and put it into envelopes and get it, which means you have to work back further and get it written. So every one of your tactics needs its own little calendar breakdown.
Yes. And you don't need to do this alone either. Make sure that you have a team, right? A lone wolf starves to death, as the saying is. So who are those partners that can help you do those things? In Hank's example of the newsletter, do you have a virtual assistant that could help? Do you have an actual physical assistant, even if it's just for newsletters, that can come in and help you do the stuffing of those envelopes?
You
Who's
have
your
teenagers.
printer?
You have teenagers that may want you to pay for their insurance.
Right. So get the team together that helps you with each of those goals that you have for next year.
And obviously you could go to howtogetherefaster.com and have a conversation with us. We get you focused on all of these 10. The sixth one, in addition to your business goals, you may have professional goals. You know, for me, in the promotional product industry, 1 year, my goal was to have the certified advertising specialty designation, which meant I had to take a certain amount of classes. I had to take 100 hours of classes, and then I had to take the test. And the test was only offered a couple of times a year. So again, going back to the calendaring, all right, when are all those classes offered? And I have to have them all done by this date because that's the date that I'm taking it. But what are those professional goals? We have a client that is a financial planner, and she has all of her CFP goals. I mean, all of her designations that she has set as professional goals, and she's working to get those done.
Number seven, riffing off of that is, okay, so you have your business goals, you have professional development goals. Now, what are your personal goals? What is it that you want to accomplish for yourself and your family in the next year? Do you need to take time off? Do you need time to spend? Make sure that gets calendared, right? If you're going to take, I don't know, if you're going to take a 4-day weekend every quarter, okay, make sure it gets calendared so that you can do that without feeling the stress of, oh my God, I promised my family I'd take this time, but I also have all these things to do for clients. So if you work backwards and create that calendar, you'll be more likely to be set and be able to relax during that 4-day vacation.
You know, for us, one of those personal goals was to take an actual vacation. Last year, we got on a cruise ship. This year, we got on a cruise ship after spending almost a week in Barcelona, and we went from Barcelona to Rome on a cruise ship. Next year, you know, going back to that goal we set 2 years ago, we've already set a cruise for next year, and we're looking at the one for the year after that. So that goal that we had 3 years ago to make sure we had vacation time, we've reenacted that goal. We've re-upped that goal so that we always take time. And look, another one of our goals has been in effect since we got married 30 years ago. We always take our anniversary off. You can't get us. Our phones are off. You know, there are a couple of days during the year, and one of them is our anniversary.
Okay.
The next one is yours, number eight.
Number eight, don't get distracted.
Yes, like when I was talking, Sharon was listening, saying, "Oh, we get to take our big, you get to take our anniversary off. How fun." And she was thinking about our anniversary and all the things we do.
Yes. So often we find that our clients or our prospects, folks we run into, they have shiny object syndrome, right? We all get these emails that are, hey, buy this really cool tool. And then you wind up spending an hour clicking on the link and going off. Wait, where was I? I actually went to my email to go do something specific. So don't get distracted by shiny object syndrome.
That has happened to me.
Me too.
See, I'll be looking at a window on my computer. And it's like, okay, I'm done with this, and I'll close it. It's like, and then there's a window behind it. Oh, that's where I was before I took two or three. We get it. Look, it happens to all of us. So just keep in mind, shiny object syndrome, it's something you do want to avoid. Yeah, and the number nine really should be Sharon's because she's the best at this. Live out of your calendar, not your inbox. Planning your day and blocking it. You know, you're much better at talking about planning. Look, I'm not allowed to put things into the calendar because
I live by the calendar.
Yeah.
So yes, block out time. You don't really need to. Well, I should say most business owners don't really need to live in their inbox. There's nothing that's so urgent that if it didn't get addressed in a couple of hours, it would be life-threatening. So block out the times when you can check your email, but in between, what are those things that you really need to get done? If you were going to lose power in an hour, what is the one thing you absolutely positively must get done today? Go do that thing. Then you can check email.
Yeah. Although if power goes off, most of the one things that we have to get done are going to happen because the power went off.
We did learn that during a power outage. It was like, yeah. We're kind of, I guess we're cleaning the house.
Read a book, take a nap. We could handwrite a blog. Oh, but then I'd have to retype it again. Yeah. So All right, the last one, take a breath, relax, give yourself some credit. You've started a business. Look back a couple of years. Where have you come from a couple of years ago, farther back? You know, we've just started doing a particular webinar that has to do with sales, and one of the things in that webinar we talk about is where our company started. And I look back, I did this for a dozen years before Sharon even came on board. So, wow, that made business much better and much easier. Give yourself some credit. And if you, at any time you're creating that inflection point in your business, it can be scary. It's like, okay, I have to make that decision. Yeah, you are going to, but most of the time it's just business. You know, you're alive, you're healthy, you're breathing. That is important. Learn to let go of some of the things that no longer work for you. When we talk about marketing tactics, we look at every marketing tactic on a quarterly basis to see if it still serves us. For example, being a member of a chamber of commerce. All right, we've been in several, like a lot of them. And we don't just look at that being a member of a chamber as one thing. Well, we break that down. Each of those chambers, are they bringing us business? Are they bringing us joy? If not, well, it's time to get rid of them. So get rid of the stuff that doesn't serve you. Embrace some new, some untried and uncomfortable things. It's okay. The only way we can get better sometime is to try those things that are new.
Expand your comfort zone.
Yeah. So that should get you started for next year. And we already mentioned it once, but if you want, reach out to us, howtogettherefaster.com, because we want to help you get there faster.com. You get a free 30-minute all about your business call. You know, we call it your get your business focused call. It is not a sales call. Here's the entire sales thing part. If you want to talk to us about coaching, and then we give you the website, companymarketingplan.com. There, the other 29 minutes, 45 seconds is all about you. So we look forward to helping you now, helping you in the new year, helping you when you need it. So we'll see you next time, everybody. And remember, if everything happens for a reason,
be the reason things happen.
See you, everybody.